When we introduced IP, we mentioned that the value of an IP address increases in the same pattern as the ticking of a clock. One of the special IP addresses we'll be discussing today is, in fact, one that signifies the beginning of time. 0.0.0.0. Hello guys, we'll talk about special IP addresses. From now onwards, we shall be using new terms to refer to devices on computer networks, host and node. A node on a computer network is any device connected to that network. This includes hubs, routers, switches, desktop computer, servers. Basically, any device on a computer network is a node. A host is a node that participates in user applications, either as a server, client computer, or both. Devices like a desktop computer, router, layer 3 switch, and server are all hosts. Basically, a host is any device on an IP network with at least one IP address. This means hubs and layer 2 switches cannot be called hosts. On this network, we have 13 nodes and only 7 hosts. Lastly, the term end system or end station refers to any device located at the edge of a network, such as these. When we say end-to-end communication, we mean communication between one end device and another. Moving on, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button and turn on bell notifications so you'll be the first to know when we release a new video like this one. You know that moment you're about to fill a form and you have a spot for a spouse? Well, if you're single, you're most likely feeling not available. However, to do this using an IP address is simple. Just fill in 0.0.0.0. Generally, the IP address 0.0.0.0 means an unknown, invalid, or non-applicable target. On computer networks, the meaning of this address may vary depending on whether the host is a client computer or a server. What does loopback mean? To loopback means to send something from yourself to yourself. It's like throwing a boomerang. In computer networking, any packet sent to a loopback address never leaves the device that originated it. The entire process of signal generation, transmission, reception, and processing takes place within the device itself. What are these loopback addresses? This is a server with an IP address. Let's visualize this server as a building such as a shopping complex. In here, there are shops. In these shops, there are attendants. James knows and carries out the procedures to help customers buy electronics from shop number 1. Danielle carries out the procedures for the use of catering services in shop number 5. Mohammed knows the procedures for buying clothes from shop number 12, and so on. In networking, this building is a server with IP address 192.168.1.1. The shops define the services provided by the server. The attendants are the protocols or applications that need to run for those services to be delivered to clients. And finally, the shop number defines the port number of the service you need to use. Every application running on a server can listen to only one IP address. This IP address does not have to be unique, but the port number must be. So, if a client needs to use web services on this server, it should connect to 192.168.1.1 on port 80 or 443. Every application on the server can be used externally by other devices on the network. But if you need a service to be accessed only by the server itself, use a loopback address. A loopback address for IPv4 is any address that begins with 127. If a user application is configured to listen to 127.0.0.1, it makes this application accessible by processes running on this server alone. This loopback address is called localhost address. Since loopback addresses allow a device to send IP packets to itself, they are used for diagnostics, such as testing if a device is correctly configured to implement TCP/IP, or if the network card of a device is faulty. Web developers use loopback addresses to test their applications locally before deploying on an actual web server. If any host attempts to send a packet to 127.0.0.1, this packet will never leave the local host because the destination IP address is a loopback address. Finally, since every application can only listen to one IP address, what happens if this application is configured to listen to 0.0.0.0? In this scenario, the application will listen to any IP address configured on this local machine, which includes all IP addresses on physical interfaces and loopback addresses. We'll learn about the few remaining special IP addresses in the next video. Until then, thank you for watching.